Hello friends, I am R.M. Guru, working as assistant professor in civil engineering department of Sharada Institute of Technology, College of Engineering. This is module number 3, plain table survey. The method of resection is the process of determining the plotted position of the station occupied by the plain table by means of site taken towards known point, location of which have been plotted earlier. So there are four methods of resection. They are: by compass we can do the resection, by backsetting we can do the resection, by 2-point problem and 3-point problem. These are the methods of resection. So in the method of resection, suppose it is required to establish a station at position P. Let us select two points A and B on the ground. The distance AB is measured and plotted to any suitable scale. The line AB is known as baseline. Then the table is set up at A. It is leveled, centered and oriented by bisecting the ranging rod at B. Then the table is clamped. With the allotted touching point small a, the ranging rod at P is bisected and a ray is drawn. Then a point P1 is marked on this way by estimating with I. Then the table is shifted and centered in such a way that P1 is just over P. It is then oriented by backsetting the ranging rod at A. With the allotted touching point B, the ranging rod at capital B is bisected and a ray is drawn. Suppose this ray intersects the previous ray at a station P, this point represents the position of station P on the sheet. Then the actual position of the station is marked on the ground by U-fork and plumb bob. Then resection by compass. This method is used only for small scale or rough mapping. Let capital A and B are the two visible stations which have been plotted on the sheet as small a and b. Let C be the instrument station to be located on the plan. Set the pen table at C and orient it with compass. Clamp the table, pivoting the allotted about A, and draw a ray towards A. As similarly, pivoting the allotted about B, draw a ray towards B as BB. The intersection of A and BB will give you the point C on the paper. This slide refers to method of resection where the station A and P, where the plane table are shown with small a as a point representing ground point capital A, whereas small p is going to represent capital point P on the ground, and B is the position where another ranging rod is held, and P1 is the position of point P, capital P, on the paper. Then we are going to see another method of resection, namely 2-point problem. In this problem, two well-defined points whose position have been plotted on the plan are selected. Then by perfectly bisecting these points, a new station is established at the required position. Then considering the 2-point problem, in this problem, two well-defined points whose position have been plotted on the plan are selected. Then by perfectly bisecting these points, a new station is established at the required position. Suppose P and Q are the two well-defined points whose positions are plotted on a map as small p and small q. It is required to locate a new station at A by perfectly bisecting P, capital P and Q. Then an auxiliary station be selected at a suitable position. The table is set up at B and leveled and oriented by I estimation. It is then clamped. With the allotted touching small p and small q, the point capital P and capital Q are bisected and rays are drawn. Suppose these rays intersect at B. With the allotted center on B, the ranging rod at A is bisected and rays is drawn. Then by I estimation, a point A1 is marked on this way. The table is shifted and centered on A with A1 just over capital A. It is leveled and oriented by backsetting. With the allotted touching small p, the point P is bisected and a ray is drawn. Suppose this ray intersect the line BA1 at point A1 as was assumed. Then with the LED is centered on A1, the point Q is bisected and ray is drawn. Suppose this ray intersect the ray BQ at point Q1, the triangle PQQ1 is known as triangle of error and is to be eliminated. Then the LED is placed along the line PQ1 and a ranging rod R is fixed at some distance from the table. Then the LED is placed along the line PQ and the table is turned to bisect the point R. At this position, the table is said to be perfectly oriented. Finally, with the LED centered on small p and q, the points P and Q are bisected and rays are drawn. Suppose these rays intersect at point A, this would represent the exact position of the required station capital A. Then the station A is marked on the ground by transferring or by making use of U-fork. Again, the LED is placed along the line AC and the point C is bisected and the table is clamped. With the LED touching small a, that is point on the paper, the point capital B is bisected and a ray is drawn. Suppose this ray intersects the previous ray at point D. The LED is placed along the DB line and the point B is bisected. At this position, the table is said to be perfectly oriented. Now the rays AA, BB and CC are drawn. These rays must meet at a point small p, which is the required position on the map. This point is transferred to the ground by U-fork and plumber. This slide refers to two-point problem where capital P and capital Q, these are the two well-defined objects on the field, and their plotted position are shown as small p and small q. And B and A, these are the two plane table positions where the plane table is to be set up. So here, initially at station B, we are trying to consider any point B, and we are trying to bring the point small b exactly over the capital B. And with position P and Q on the paper and by B as a position of plane table, we are trying to establish a line of sight with P and we are trying to establish a line of sight with Q. And A1 is a position of point A. Since we are not going to measure the distance BA, we are tentatively marking the point A1 by our estimation. Then the instrument is shifted at point A, and then by placing the plane LED along the ray A1B and by placing the ranging rod at B, we are trying to establish a line of sight. And then with station at A1, we are trying to establish a line of sight with P and Q so that the rays are going to meet at point P and in between. So here the PQQ1, this is called error of triangle. So in order to eliminate this particular error of triangle, we are going to consider any point R on the right side of the table, and then by loosening the clamp screw and by placing the plane LED along the line small pq, we are trying to bisect the point R. So when we are doing so, we are doing the proper orientation. Then coming to 3-point problem, in this problem, three well-defined points are selected whose position have been plotted on the map. Then by perfectly bisecting these three well-defined points, a new station is established at the required position. Here in this particular case, no auxiliary station is required as in case of 2-point problem. To solve this particular problem, this table is directly placed at the required position. The problem may be solved by following methods, namely Bessel's method, mechanical method, and trial and error method. So in 3-point problem of graphical method or Bessel's method, we are going to consider the A, B, and C, the three well-defined points, which have been plotted as small a, b, and c. Now it is required to locate a station at P. The plane table is placed at the required station P and labeled. Then the LED is placed along the line CA and the point A is bisected. The table is clamped with the LED in center on C. The point B is bisected and ray is drawn. Here which is shown in the first operation. Similarly, with the station pin at A, the C point is bisected. Similarly, in the third operation, we are going to get the one point, and it is a point from which all the station A, B, C are established. So in this method, we are going to see the mechanical method of three-point problem. Suppose A, B, and C are the three well-defined points which have been plotted on the map as small a, b, and c. It is required to locate a station at P. The table is placed at P and labeled. A touching paper is fixed on the map and a point P is marked on it. With the aggregate centered on P, the points A, B, and C are bisected and rays are drawn. These rays may not pass through the points A, B, and C as the orientation is done approximately. Now, a tracing paper is unfastened and moved over the map in such a way that three rays simultaneously pass through the plotted position A, B, and C. Then the point P is prickled with a pin to give an impression small p on the map. P is the required point on the map. The tracing paper is then removed. Then the aggregate is centered on P and the rays are drawn towards A, B, and C. These rays must pass through the points small a, small b, and c. This figure shows the typical sketch of mechanical method where capital A, B, and C, these are the well-defined points, and small a, small b, small c, these are the required, these are the plotted position of capital A, B, and C, and P1 is the position where the instrument is to be set up, and P1 is the position of plane table station on map. So in this slide, we are going to see three-point problem where the method to be considered is trial and error. Suppose A, B, and C are the three well-defined points which have been plotted as A, B, C on the map. Now it is required to establish a station at P. Then the table is set up at P and labeled. Orientation is done by eye estimation. Then with the aggregate, rays A, B, B, C, C are drawn. As the orientation is approximately, the rays may not intersect at a point but vary from small to form a small triangle called triangle of error. To get the actual point, this error of triangle is to be eliminated by repeatedly turning the table clockwise or anticlockwise. The triangle is eliminated in such a way that the rays A, B, B, and C, C finally meet at a point P. This is the required point on the map. This point is transferred to the ground by U-fork and plumber. So whenever we are going to carry out the plane table surveying, following points are to be considered while preparing a plan or a map of any locality, maybe small, maybe medium. The ground points shall be marked as capital ABC, whereas the points corresponding point on the paper should be shown with small letters such as small a, b, c. The rays from survey station to the object shall be drawn by dashed line. Then the aggregate should be properly pivoted while sighting the object. Then the first survey station and the scale of map shall be so chosen that the entire area can be plotted on the paper. While establishing magnetic north on the paper using trip compass, things causing local attraction shall be kept away from the table. And finally, the plane table should be clamped after centering and leveling. The table should be rotated at the time of orientation only. This slide refers to method of trial and error in three-point problem, where the capital A, capital B, and capital C, these are the three well-defined objects on the site, whereas small a, small b, and small c, these are the corresponding location on the paper, and small p is the position of point P, whereas capital P is the position of point on the ground. So when the line of sights are established, it is going to form the triangle of error, which is shown in this particular diagram. So we have to eliminate and where to come or where to select one of the point which may lie at a single station, and then they should eliminate to have the line of sight starting from P to A, P to B, and P to C respectively. This slide refers to errors in plane table surveying, First is instrumental error, second is errors in manipulation and sighting, and third is error in plotting. The instrumental error consists of the surface of drawing board is not a plane, the edge of LED is not straight, the object when and sight when are not perpendicular to the LED, the edge of LED is not parallel to the line of sight, the fixing clamp is not proper. This slide shows the errors in manipulation and sighting. It is defective leveling, defective sighting, defective orientation, defective centering, movement of board between sides. So these are errors on account of manipulation and sighting. So in the method of resection, suppose it is required to establish a station at position P. Let us select two points A and B on the ground. Thank you.